Coming up on Motor City Motors. The Detroit brothers push the boundaries of both engineering and the imagination with a hamster wheel on steroids. Join us now as two custom bike builders, artist Jamie.
I love that stuff, though. Like going against the grain.
And engineer Dave.
A squared plus B squared equals C squared.
Lead a crew of local builders.
That's how Detroit does it, baby!
To create another outrageous vehicle.
That's awesome.
And inspire a struggling city. On Motor City Motors. Take a 1991 Ford Festiva and turn it into a massive rolling hamster wheel mobile.
The funnest project we've done yet.
They have 5 days, five local Detroit builders, and a city that's counting on them. If by midnight on day five, they can successfully do a full lap around the garage, each builder takes home an economic stimulus package. $5,000 in tools from Cobalt, Bailey, Miller Welding, and Ranger.
We went to the Heidelberg project this morning. We went there for some inspiration. Tyree Guyton is the founder and designer of this urban art project that's been going on in Detroit for 20 years now. So he's kind of been like this elusive artist that nobody I knew ever got to meet him.
I'm James.
Hey, James, I'm Tyree.
Nice to meet you, Tyree.
You Dave. So how long have you been doing this?
You know, 23 years.
23 years.
And I'm 26.
Oh, that's
amazing. Yeah.
Yeah. Jamie, I want to hit your book.
Jamie asked him to sign his sketchbook, and so Tyree drew a dot for him.
You got this on tape, right? This is awesome.
And then Tyree asked us to sign his street, so he had us draw a couple of dots on his street, which was really cool.
Always gonna be different.
Jamie painted a square. Square, no you didn't. You're dangerous. You go, wild boy.
It's gotta be different.
You know, kind of getting inspired by this. This is, it's really cool, but it's crazy, like a circus. So what's the idea gonna be?
We need to make the wheelbase as short as possible. I like the idea of keeping this. It's got a cool back part, a cool front part. So I like taking it out of the middle here. So we chop this out, you know?
I think we should extend the axles though, because we want this thing to be, that car is only this wide.
The brothers' plan is to cut the middle out of the Festiva and weld it back together. Then they'll extend the axles outside the body, allowing the car to fit inside a new pair of giant steel wheels.
It's gonna have independent brakes so we can make it turn, at least in theory.
Next, they'll install brakes on each wheel and levers on the car's roof to activate the brakes. Crank one brake and the car turns that direction. Both, and it comes to a stop. Which means the brothers must drive perfectly in sync to avoid a disaster in the hamster wheel mobile.
This is gonna be silly looking, man. It's gonna be cool, though. The beauty of this build is that there's no real reason to do this, which is what makes it so fun. We're just building it just to build it.
It'd be awesome.
That's good.
It's a good little car.
Yeah. Well, let's bring the builders in.
Sculptor and metalworker Gianna Ball. Artist and custom car builder Keith Coleman. Master fabricator, Jeff Maxwell. Pro mechanic, Paul Arp. And jack of all metalwork, Jeff Evarts.
The idea is that, as you can kind of see from the pictures, it's going to run in these trails. It's going to run both of these wheels and, in theory, propel this thing forward. Before we make this, we got to cut this car down. So we got to take a good 30, 35 inches out of the drivetrain. So, I mean, if we can get that done by tomorrow, we'll be in great shape to actually make this deadline.
Yep, get you guys some tools at the end of the week.
Good luck.
The clock starts now. For this build, Motor City Motors is going co-ed.
All right, cool.
Yeah, first woman on the build. That's a good thing.
I work for General Motors. I'm a clay sculptor. Being a woman in shop situations, like I said, can be really intimidating just to come in.
The other guys will be able to pick up her slack, I'm sure. No, I didn't.
I know what I'm doing, you know, metal shop-wise, so once you prove yourself as being somebody that can hang with the boys, I think they're happy to have you along.
So we should have a couple inches outside of the widest point, right, just so we don't have any clearance problems.
With the teardown underway, Dave and Jeff tackle the first major design issue: how to extend the axles outside the car's body so they'll fit into their hamster wheels.
We can get a couple of junkyard hubs, so we just weld a pipe on here and put a fresh hub, and then leave all of this alone.
We just put an extended mount. That's a great idea.
That'll save us a ton of time.
34-year-old Jeff started his career as a fabricator 34 years ago.
As close to being born with a wrench in my hand as possible. I was learning how to use power tools, like, as soon as I was old enough to stand up on a little stepladder.
Now Jeff owns IF Metalworks, a successful Detroit company specializing in custom-built metal creations.
Everything from military vehicle components to architectural metalwork, spires and railings and stuff you see on some very fancy buildings around town. Pretty much anything made out of metal.
Jeff's got the tools to build some of the city's most unique structures.
This is, if not the biggest, one of the biggest flat build tables in Detroit. The whole Mackinac Bridge that we did for the Detroit Science Center was built on this table in 16-foot sections. Taking on as many crazy projects as we can because they're fun.
The Festiva is torn down to just a shell. Now, it's time to crack it. The team needs to cut almost 3 feet out of the middle of the car, and the Festiva is perfect for the job. The front wheel drive means it's propelled by the front wheels alone, so they can chop away without disturbing any of the car's mechanics.
We just cut it, whatever happens, happens.
Yes.
We'll make it work. Here goes.
Turning the Festiva into a hamster wheel is right up Keith's alley.
Cars and motorcycles can definitely be pieces of art in my eyes. And I think my cars and motorcycles are art.
Keith works out of his own garage, building custom hot rods and motorcycles.
I've been building cars and choppers and hot rods since about 1972.
This car is built on a skeleton method, which is just like it sounds. First you make the skeleton, you can make any shape you want.
But Keith's art isn't just confined to custom cars.
An art thing.